In the previous video, we have learned sort of like an overview of projectile motion. So now I'm going to discuss a few special cases for projectile motion. So I mentioned that projectile motion is like something that you launch into the air. When it's in the air, then there's no forces acting on it except for the gravity, the only force acting on it. And because the only force acting on the object is gravity, then the motion traced by the object will be a projectile path, so therefore it's called projectile motion. Okay, so there are many ways for us to launch something into the air. You can launch something like using a cannon, then you can launch something like this. Or if you drop something from the air, you drop something, then it falls down. This is also a kind of launching something into the air, because initially it's touching something, then the moment you drop it, it's no longer touching anything, so the only forces acting on it is also the gravity only. To launch something using a cannon, then the moment it's on in the air, there's nothing touching it, so the only force acting on it is the gravity. Let's say if you are having an aeroplane flying across the sky, then suddenly drop something from the aeroplane. Let's say you drop a parcel from the aeroplane. Then before that, the aeroplane is touching the parcel, so there's other forces acting on it. But the moment the parcel drops from the aeroplane, there's only the parcel in the air. There's nothing touching it, so the only forces acting on it is the gravity. So when the parcel is flying through the air, it's also a projectile motion. The point I'm trying to show you these examples here is to tell you that there are many ways for us to launch a projectile motion or to start a projectile motion. So let's look at a few special cases on how we create this kind of projectile motion. Okay, I'm going to focus on the angle where we launch our motion, we launch our projectile motion. If we launch our projectile motion at an angle of 0, what will happen? If we launch our projectile motion at an angle of 90 degrees, launching vertically upwards, what will happen? Okay, so let's look at the first one. If we launch our projectile motion at an angle of 0, means by we are launching our projectile motion along a horizontal line. So you can think of it like a cannon, but the cannon is pointing horizontal. So you push out something from the cannon in the horizontal direction. So what will happen is your path will still be a parabolic path, but the parabola is only half the parabola, because you are starting from the highest point over here. Last time we usually start at somewhere below, then you launch something upwards, then it falls back down, right? But if today you start your motion at the highest point, then you trace half a parabola. So this is a path traced by an object if it's launched at an angle of 0 with respect to the horizontal. So the horizontal is like this. You launch at an angle which is 0 degree compared to the horizontal. So this kind of situation, we call it a horizontal projectile. So this initial velocity is only in the x component. The initial velocity in the y component is 0. Okay, so the initial velocity here, it's all in the x component. So you can see the initial velocity, it's all in the x component. But for the y component, there's nothing. Okay, because you're not launching it upwards, there's no component upwards, there's no component downwards. Initially, initially it's horizontal. So it's 0 over here. Again, this is for projectile motion. So the x component of acceleration is 0. The y component is negative 9.81. So this is one kind of projectile motion. We call it one special case, and we call this special case the horizontal projectile. Okay? Now we move on to look at another special case. This special case is if we launch it at 90 degrees with respect to the horizontal. So the horizontal, the ground is like this. So if you launch it at an angle of 90 degrees, you will launch it upwards, or you can launch it downwards 90 degrees, something like this. You launch it downward 90 degrees. So you can have an option like this where you are launching it upwards for an angle of 90 degrees. So you go upwards then fall back down. All this motion here are happening on one single line. It's a one dimensional motion. I put it sort of like a U-turn because I don't want you to confuse the upward motion and the downward motion. But actually they are all happening on the same line here. Okay, this is what happens if you launch it upwards, then it falls back down. Okay, if you launch it from the highest point, means when you stand at the highest point, then you drop an object, then it would be something like this. You're dropping it 90 degrees with respect to the horizontal as well, just that it's dropping from the highest point, speeding up until it hits the ground. So this is also a kind of special case. So this kind of special case where we launch at an angle of 90 degrees, we call it a freefall motion. Because all the motion here are happening in the y dimension only. If it's happening in the y dimension only, and the only force acting on it is gravity, we call this kind of motion the free fall motion. Okay, so for free fall motion, since everything is happening in the y component, there's nothing in the x component, we can just cross out our x component. So we will not deal with the x component. For the y component, our initial velocity here will be totally our y component of initial velocity. Okay, there's no split into x component anymore. Everything is for the y component. Okay, of course, if you drop it from up here, then the initial velocity will be zero because you drop it from up here. Initially, it's zero velocity. Then it slowly starts to speed up, and y component of initial velocity will be zero for these kind of cases over here. Okay. But still, the y component of acceleration is negative 9.81 meter per second. So these are the two special cases, the horizontal projectile and the free fall. But don't need to worry too much about it. Any kind of projectile motion, no matter the special cases or the not so special cases, you solve it using the same strategy, the five steps. Visualize initial and final position, SUVAT, SUVAT, your table, get your equation, substitute and get answer. It's always these five steps, and we are going to apply it in a few questions in the next videos.